And that's what brings us to the biggest cut of all.
Which was?
The wait.
Order's ready in 30 seconds, not 30 minutes.
Mecca.
We look at each other one night.
You thinking what I'm thinking?
We're gonna have to tear down, rebuild, rethink the whole dang thing.
We're talking about shutting down a thriving business for months.
People are gonna think we're crazy.
We were crazy.
And you were gonna love how we did it, Dick? You gotta tell him.
Tennis court?
Okay. He brings me out to this tennis court, and he's drawn this line, the exact dimensions of our kitchen.
Sink on the right, extruder on the left.
Extruder.
Bagging and hood.
Hood.
Okay.
Garnish.
This is
burger finish.
Got it.
And then this is burger slide.
We could just move those.
Okay.
Want to mix your soft drinks.
Okay.
We bring out our whole staff, and we have them go through the motions, making pretend burgers and fries.
All right, Steve, anticipate that.
You got to keep the tray level.
Okay.
And Dick is running around with his stick, marking where all the equipment should be.
Tuck in. Tony, are you going to skip the pickles when we're really doing it?
They do it over and over, hashing it out, choreographing it like some crazy burger ballet. What's
going on over there?
Yes. No. No. Everybody stop! Stop!
Garnish one. Garnish two. You've got pickles, you've got onions. It's a goddamn hamburger.
Come on, clear off.
Let's clear it off.
It's time for the pink chalk. And then root beer orange. See all this open space here now? We've rearranged the fry situation, so now it's stage left, the deep fryer stage right. Begin.
That's great.
Come on, guys.
They're pretty tied up here.
Yeah, watch it.
The Lazy Susan.
It's the timing of the Lazy Susan.
Those are finished burgers. You can't... Hold it.
I still think there's a third version.
What do you want to move?
I want to move everything. Back to stage left, please.
Think we got it all drawn. This is better.
Is that all right?
I think so. I guess let's assume our battle station.
Okay.
Finally, after about 6 hours of this, we get it just right. It's a symphony of efficiency, not a wasted motion.
Good form, Jasper.
I feel good about those pickles.
Ketchup!
Use your Lazy Susan. Put your back into it, Seth. And pickles and pickle and mustard.
We take the layout to a builder, custom build the kitchen to our exact specs.
Ta-da, the Speed-D system is born, the world's first ever system to deliver food fast. It is totally revolutionary.
And a complete disaster.
Why? Opening day, cars pull up onto the lot, and they start honking immediately because no car hop comes up.
You place your order.
We try to explain to them the walk-up window, and they are bewildered. No, they're furious. What do you mean I gotta get out of my car? Most of them just cuss us out and drive off, and the few that stay are mad as heck because they're eating off paper and they've got to discard their own trash.
Why? You're doing great. You're doing great.
Yeah, we won't be coming out to the car, but you can just come on up.
Welcome to McDonald's.
We may have underestimated the learning curve.
So by 5 o'clock, Dick is calculating how much it's going to cost to go back to driving. But I am not ready to throw in the towel. I go back to our old Hollywood days. I think to myself, we got to go big with this. We got to put on a show. So I say, Dick, I want to throw a grand reopening, a gala premiere that would put Louis B. Mayer to shame. So we rent a bunch of spotlights. Same ones we used to haul around in the Columbia days to get sparklers, a juggler for the kiddies. It is an event. People show up in droves. And then
the flies. They must have been drawn by all the lights.
Millions of them. It was like a scene out of Exodus.
The Pharaoh would have released the Israelites.